Hello student, welcome back. And today we are going to learn about 3.4 body mass index BMI. So in this chapter, we can learn whether that you are healthy or not. So now I want to give you a project. It's not a project, it's just a very simple thing on it. I want you to check whether you are healthy or not. So I want to check whether you are healthy or not. So I want you to use this BMI formula, get your body mass. So I think my body mass is around 57 kg. My height will be around 170 cm. But I convert to meter. I remember to convert to meter. So it's 1.7 meter. So 1.7, I get 57 divided by 1.7, I will get 33.5. So let's see I'm healthy or not. 33.5 overweight. What? Actually I'm quite thin eh. That's weird. 50. Yeah, I forget to put power of 2 because I need to put power of 2. So let's do again. My weight is 57 kg divided by my height is 1.7 power of 2. So you press your calculator, I will get 19.7. So 19.7 by BMI is actually at here. So it's desirable weight. Actually I'm almost to, I'm very thin now, if you can see. So I'm very thin but still okay lah. That's why you can see it's around here already. Little bit more I will become how to say it, underweight. So you can check your weight and see whether you are underweight or overweight or what. I want you to try to press so that I want to leave at the comment below and tell me whether you are underweight, desirable weight, overweight or obese. But I know you won't do that lah. Just ask for fun. But you can do that if you want to. Calculate the body mass, commonly known as BMI. So yeah, so we are calculating body mass index. So far I would say BMI is quite accurate because some people are saying that BMI not accurate, maybe due to bone mass, due to different region, different country. But I think it is still ideal lah, huh? It is still ideal. Okay, it still can reasonable graph lah, huh? And we can see that here, studies show that people last time with ideal BMI, which 18.9 to 24.9, live a longer life. So if you have a good BMI, then you will live a longer life lah. The thing is, some people might think, I don't live a longer life than also fine. The thing is, you will waste a lot of money because you won't, maybe you won't sleep until die. Some people just they sleep and then they die. But some people they got heart attack, they got stroke, they got paralyzed, they got Parkinson disease and so on. So these are the way that not to die. I know you are still young, you never think of how to die, but when the moment you think how to die, it might be too late. So I don't know why I'm talking this, but we should plan our life, like what we should study, what we should work, who to marry, and also we should plan how to die. So that we die in the most I don't know, the most meaningful way to die, and the least painful and the most meaningful way to die. Some people die due to COVID 30 years old and they leave their children. So these are really not a good way to die. Of course I know someone that 30 plus he died, but he's quite fat, you know, so he's not that healthy. So and he died never mind, and he leave the children. So that's the thing. So please take care of your health. Plan everything, must plan properly, plan your study, plan your future. If you don't plan, then many things will happen. Like the statement say, Those that fail to plan are planning to fail. Okay, interpreting body mass index. So you need to be healthy so that you can avoid heart attack, high blood pressure, stroke, diabetes, mellitus, and so on, and joint bone. So usually people die of heart attack, die of heart blood pressure, die of stroke, die of diabetes, and die of cancer. I mean, these are the few common things that people die lah. So being underweight also can have a lot of disease, such as heart disease, decrease in body defense against disease, fatigue means very tired, anemia, not enough of red blood cell. But if you are got anemia, you also have fatigue lah. Usually anemia, you can see the person's face is like white color, but my face is still brown color, so it's still okay. But if the person face pucat lah, anemia, depression. So depression means too sad lah, very 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 sad, like maybe always cry, always has negative thought, always keep himself in the room and cry many time, and this is the symptom of depression, or maybe thinking of suicide. Okay, nevertheless, achieving and maintaining an ideal body weight through a healthy diet and physical exercise. So make sure that you are healthy and always do physical exercise. Like me, I mean not like me, but at least I got do lah. In 1 week, I will exercise on Sunday, Tuesday, and Thursday. So I make it interval and I exercise so that you can be healthy. Not only be healthy, you will be beautiful. The reason is when you exercise, your blood will go to your brain, so it makes you smarter if you exercise. Secondly, if you exercise, you also will become more handsome or beautiful. The reason is because your blood will go to your skin, and eventually your skin will be more more beautiful lah, rather than the person that don't exercise. So you see that usually the people that go Olympic they exercise a lot. You can see that. I think it's fair to say that people that exercise more, they are more, their face is more radiant and more bright. If you go to Olympic, usually their face is also a bit young. If you always see a friend that always don't exercise, maybe they will get old faster, something like that. Why? Ways to increase body mass. So again, eat more lah, huh? Eat more. They changed the food pyramid already, you know. Last time, they changed the food pyramid is like this one, okay, like this, and down here is rice. So the reason is if you put rice down there, you don't eat so much of rice because the rice will cause diabetes. That's why a lot of people you got diabetes because you eat a lot of rice, and it caused diabetes. So now the pyramid, they remove the rice already. And you can see that this is the Malaysian healthy plate. Okay, so now they change to something more like this. 50% is vegetable and fruit, 25% is meat, and 25%, for example, is rice, oat, noodle, cereal. I prefer to eat cereal lah, huh? Morning when I break up, usually I eat overnight oat. Eat until I want to vomit lah, because every morning I wake up and eat the same thing. I mix lah, overnight oat with berries, nut, yogurt, milk. If you know how to mix overnight oat, it tastes very nice, but I'm busy lah, so I just simply put. Now also when I'm recording this video is now is 12:40 a.m. So I'm going to record this video and then I will go to sleep. Okay. So it's one of the way to increase the body mass, and way to decrease body mass. This one you need to know lah, because this one also can help to for karangan lah. You can write set realistic goal, eat lesser, eat in moderation, don't eat so much McDonald's, reduce high calorie food. For example, reduce fat content, do exercise 30 minutes a week, walking, cycling, swimming, and so on. And Yeah, so these are the few ways to, I mean, I don't want to go too much lah, you know lah, huh? Karangan. So you know lah how to reduce the body mass. So yeah, now, wow, he will even give you a very healthy person. Here, So what is the meaning of body mass index? So we can find the answer is body mass index is, I should highlight this only. Okay, wait, I just want to undo. Wait, how to undo? Okay, is the measurement, BMI is the measurement of body mass against height. Okay, that is BMI. And let's move on. What is the importance of calculating body mass index? Why is it important to know BMI? So of course the reason we want to use BMI is to determine whether we are overweight, normal or underweight. We can know that we are our condition of health in our body, so that maybe I can write that to detect whether we are obese, underweight, to detect whether we are overweight, normal or underweight, to prevent possibility of getting disease. Okay, correct or not? So that you won't get disease lah. When you get disease means he's not talking about COVID. Disease like diabetes, disease like heart attack or stroke. So these are the disease. Okay. If you are fat, then you are more chances to have heart attack and stroke. Correct or not? If a person is fat. Okay, if you have BMI of 30, which category are you are in? So 30, the person is overweight, or I would say obesity. Okay, obese, the person is obese. What are the risks of obese? So maybe I will say heart attack, stroke. Okay, heart attack or stroke. The reason is because you obese ma, so you are fat. So when you are fat, you got a lot of cholesterol. Cholesterol usually your blood vessel, this blood vessel, the fat will stuck in your blood vessel. They will like accumulate beside your blood vessel. So when they accumulate like a pipe, the pipe becomes smaller and smaller because your fats make the pipe smaller. But when the pipe is so small, the vessel is so small, it will burst. So it will be called stroke. So it could be happen in your body, it could happen in your brain, because you are too fat, the fats accumulate at your vessel, and let's say the vessel break in your brain, you got stroke, and it might even result in death, correct or not, or some part of the blood start to clot, blood clot, and maybe the blood cannot move. So what happens when the blood cannot move? The heart don't know, the heart, not that clever, and the heart will continue to pump, because cannot miss, it will pump harder, pump until cannot pump, because the heart like do, then suddenly ding, because the heart already failed, the heart failure. So it could cause heart attack also. If you are underweight, will we be set free from health issue? So this is more like the K-Bud question. Justify your answer. If you are underweight, will it be free from health issue? No. I mean, it's not healthy to be underweight. I think it depends on how much underweight you are. Some people are underweight until very much like anorexia nervosa, very 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 thin. It's a psychological disease. Okay, so we can see this is the example of a lady suffer from anorexia nervosa, which actually he don't want to eat lah, huh? He think he He just don't want to eat. He want to be thin and beautiful. So that's why I say it depends how severe. So doesn't mean you are thin, you are healthy. If you are thin until like anorexia nervosa, means you are very unhealthy and you can even die. So too fat will die, too thin will die. Try your best to be normal, and you will be exercise, eat more vegetable and fruit to keep your skin healthy, and then I think it's good enough. Okay, so justify. So I would say no, because if you are too thin, you will have, for example, I just put one example, like you will have anemia, okay, which is actually lack of red blood cell, and severe anemia also can cause death, so, or maybe depression, a lot of things like, we can say depression, or even die from disease, because you are too skin. So let's say, can you imagine he got fever, the chances that he died from fever is more than a normal people die from fever. Okay, let's say COVID, he got COVID, the chances he died from COVID is much more likely compared to this guy. This guy got COVID maybe 2 weeks, he rest at home, then he's healed. But this girl, if she got COVID, then it's not good. Okay, oh, so fast I already finished this topic. So in this chapter, we already learn how to measure our health. We want to make sure our body temperature is good. 37, right? So you know lah, got COVID, that's why I'm dead. Pulse rate, you still remember how to count your pulse rate, Calculate your pulse rate, make sure it's good. Blood pressure, buy a machine, put in your home, and BMI that we just learned. So, okay. Maybe we can do one more question to wrap things up. Okay. You have fever and your body temperature is above 37 Celsius. Let's say it's maybe 38, 39. Extreme cold and also cause body temperature to be below. Based on the statement above, state three factors that can cause fever. Why we have fever? So maybe infection of virus. I don't know, maybe COVID, then you got virus. Could be exposure to extreme heat. Okay, exposed to heat. For example, you stand under the sun, or maybe three factors that can cause fever. And maybe I say vaccination. Because after I take my vaccine, I also got little bit fever, but only one day lah. One day then tomorrow after I sleep, then tomorrow I'm healed, and then I'm happy again. When I get sick, I become very sad and depressed. But when I'm healed, I'm happy like now. I think I'm happy. I don't know. I think I'm happy. Yeah. What to do? Yeah, life is like that lah. That's a normal life. But yeah, I thank God for my life. What is the normal body temperature? The body temperature is 36.9. Some books say 37, some books say 37. But I think more accurate will be 36.9 lah, but some book will say 37. Which type of thermometer is more suitable to infant less than 4 months old? So this is a baby. If you still remember, baby, we use a rectal thermometer. Rectal thermometer, because you put into the baby buttock. Is it? You still remember or not? It's in the notes. I still remember, even though I teach like 3 months ago. I don't want to go up lah. Very very fine. The sequence. So you need to use a rectal thermometer. Of course, you can use a infrared thermometer also. Infrared thermometer, but this one more accurate. Rectal thermometer is more accurate than infrared thermometer, because when you use infrared thermometer, it is more towards your surface, the heat surface. So sometimes if you use rectal thermometer or you put in your mouth, the thermometer put up, it's actually more accurate clinical thermometer because it measures the inside temperature, because infrared is measuring outside. But you still can use lah, huh? But you seldom see hospital like that. Teeth also, right? The doctor also give you the mouth because you want to measure inside, not outside. And the baby also use rectal thermometer. You put in the baby buttock lah. Not take this mouth one put at the baby buttock ah. It's called rectal thermometer. Okay, not the one that we put into our mouth. Okay, so that's it for this video. I hope you learn something and you enjoy it. And maybe next lesson we will continue with the following question. So I see you again. Thank you and bye bye.